Do you pay a fee to convert currency that you receive from your customers before you can transfer it into your account? Well, this video will show you how to record fees for exchanges and deposits into QuickBooks Desktop. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. In this second example, the payment we receive from Yuri will be directly deposited into the bank account. However, if you need to deduct an exchange fee, you need to make an intermediate step. You need to record the full payment in the undeposited funds account. Then, with the same date, record the payment as deposited in the deposit window. That will give you the chance to deduct the fee. For example, let's imagine on January 25th, we did legal service for Yuri Buri and we billed him for 10,000 rubles. Each ruble was $0.013 on this day, January 25th. On January 30th, he pays all 10,000 rubles. The ruble is only worth 0.012 of the dollar on that day. The loss is $10 on the exchange, just like we learned how to calculate in a prior video. And to add insult to injury, they also deducted a $20 fee for the currency exchange and the transfer of funds. So how do you handle this? Well, you would record the payment the same way that we learned in the prior video, except this time you would not choose bank account, you would instead choose undeposited funds. Then, immediately after recording the payment, you would open the deposit window and deduct the fee and record the net amount into your account. So first we record these two transactions. January 25th, we did legal service, 10,000 rubles, 0.013 for Yuri. So let's record that. Customer create invoice. The customer is Yuri Buri. The date is January 25th of 2021. Okay, now the item of service is legal services rendered. And the number of rubles on that day that we billed him for was 10,000, and they were worth 0.013. So if you're following along and yours does not say 0.013 for the exchange rate, then you type it in. Now, let's just, okay, and then he'll pay them. Oops, and then he'll pay them. So right now, let's just record this invoice. Save and close. And we look at the trial balance, we are owed 130 US dollars worth of rubles, and we just earned 130 more dollars in legal service fee. And that's the result after just recording the invoice. And now let's record the payment. On January 30, the ruble was only worth 0.012 of the dollar when we got paid all 10,000 rubles. So the loss on the exchange is $10 because we calculated just like we learned in the prior video. So what will be the result after step one? Just recording the payments into undeposited funds. Well, if they paid all 10,000 rubles, then accounts receivable rubles will go down to zero. And because they were worth 120 US dollars at the moment we received them, then undeposited funds will increase by $120 and become 2,120. And the difference is a $10 loss. Now, right now we have a $6.30 gain. But if we put in a $10 loss against a $6.30 gain, we wind up with a net loss of $3.70. And these will be the numbers just after recording the first step of receiving the payment. So we click Customers, Receive Payments. Now, we choose URI, and we know that the date we received the money is January 30. And we know that at the moment we received the money, it was only worth 0.012 of a dollar, not 0.013. So if we put in all 10,000 rubles, we're imagining we received all of the rubles that URI promised to pay, you can see that if the exchange rate on the 30th is only 0.012, that we're only getting 120 US dollars and we have a $10 loss. So we click Save and Close, and when we look at the trial balance, the numbers are exactly as what we expected. Undeposited funds went up to 2,120. Cash in bank only increased by, well, cash in bank didn't change, just undeposited 2,120. Account receivable went down to zero because they paid all of the rubles that they were supposed to pay. And the exchange gain or loss moved from the credit side to the debit side. Here, double click, take a look. It was a credit balance of $6.30, but then we made a debit of a $10 loss for this January 30th payment. So the net result is a net loss overall of $3.70 for all the exchanges. And now that we've recorded that, the very last step is to deduct out the fee and acknowledge that it actually went into the bank account. Now we're recording this deposit on the same date as the received payment, so the exchange rate will be the same. The financial institution deducted 10,000 rubles for the exchange to convert the currency to dollars and then transfer it into our Chase bank account. And the expense that they deducted, that we record for the 10,000 rubles, is an expense called exchange and transfer fees expense. And if you don't have it in your chart of accounts, you should pause the video and put it in your chart of accounts. So what will be the results after this next step? Well, the $120 will no longer be in undeposited funds. They will be moved to the bank account. So undeposited funds goes down to 2,000 and the bank account goes up to $2,648. And of course, the fee shows up as transfer fees expense in the US dollar equivalent of the 1,000 rubles that they deducted, and at this moment that equivalent is $12. And this will be the result after the last step that we finish recording the deposit and deduct the fee. From the main menu, we click Banking, Make Deposit. Now notice it's only showing us dollar payments. We have to change this to Russian ruble. And now we have all of the payments we received in rubles. Click this one because this is the one we're depositing, and we click OK. And now under the undeposited funds, we click here and we find the expense that we put on the list, exchange and transfer fees expense. Click under the 10,000 rubles and put minus 1,000 rubles. So they're deducting 1,000 rubles, okay, which is basically equal to $12 just for this transferring and exchanging and converting the currency at the moment that they put the money in our Chase bank. So our Chase bank is only going to increase by $108. and undeposited funds will go down by the 120, and of course, the exchange fee will show up as $12. When we click save and close, you can see the numbers are exactly as what we expected. Undeposited funds is 2,000 even. Cash in Chase Bank is 2,648 because only $108 was placed into the account. And after that last step, we now properly acknowledge exchange and transfer fees expense.